Well, if you have a daughter, you may be wondering, how young is too young to take her to the gynecologist? We are happy to welcome back Dr. Roz and educate us on when to take your daughter to see the doctor.
Well, it's recommended that you take your young daughter to the gynecologist between age 13 and 15.
Okay.
That's a recommendation.
Why is that
the
magical?
You know, we're always, I have two teenage daughters.
Right.
And I'm always teaching. So it's all about teaching, and it's about establishing a relationship with the patient as well.
So. And then when you take her to the gynecologist, what happens? What should you expect?
Well, you can expect a conversation. You're not going to expect to have a pelvic exam during that visit. That usually doesn't happen. That visit is mostly educational, not necessarily problem-focused.
Okay.
Problem-focused may require a pelvic examination. We try not to do that at the first time to the gynecologist. That can be a very scary thing to happen.
Right, you know, right.
So, yes.
And then when do you get a pap smear for the first time?
Well, pap smears are recommended now at age 21.
Okay.
So a lot of times I do have patients coming in, the younger patient, their mother's writing to them like, you know, you're going to have a pelvic, and they try to explain what it is. Then they're relieved to know that, oh, I don't even need to have that. And
right.
So it's a good thing. Because like I said, it's a very invasive exam. You don't want to have it if you don't need it. And studies have shown that young ladies do not develop cervical cancer because that's what the pap smear is all about. It's screening for cervical cancer.
Does the mother go in? Doesn't go in.
Well,
what's your suggestion?
Well, the suggestion is whatever's comfortable for the patient. And I could sort of, you know, when the mom is definitely in the room initially and we're having a conversation, and you can get a feel of how the patient is, how comfortable or uncomfortable she is.
Mm-hmm.
And so when it gets to a certain point, I may ask mom to step out and so that we can discuss. And it's very important to let the patient know, too, that their confidentiality, what they're sharing, is just going to be between her and I.
You want to teach them healthy decisions, too, mm-hmm. and that includes eating.
Oh, absolutely. And letting them know that there are short and long-term consequences to what they do. So that they want to develop good eating habits, good hygiene habits. And so it's just a lot of teaching and educating that's going on during that visit.
Is there an age where you can stop going to the gynecologist? Or do you, I mean, I don't know. Do you go in your 70s and 80s still?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
I have patients because there's issues. You may not need a pap smear per se, but the pelvic exam is important. And that exam is just making sure that the anatomy is as well, that there is no lesions or any pain or anything like that. We talk about osteoporosis.
Mm-hmm.
We talk about health. So there are so many reasons to come to talk to the gyno.
The shot.
The Gardasil.
The
vaccine.
Gardasil shot.
Yes.
I've heard a lot of moms. Do I let my daughter have that shot? Do I not? What?
Mm-hmm. Well, Gardasil is recommended from ages 9 to 26, and that is a vaccine to help prevent HPV infections.
Right.
And that HPV infection is the HPV, human papillomavirus, that can cause cervical cancer. So it's a vaccine against that.
Dr. Roz, how do we find you?
Well, you can go to drrozmd.com.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
A lot of answers. Thank you.